So my morning routine's done. I did 4 lengths underwater without the camera, and then I tried it with the camera in my hand, and obviously I could only do 3 lengths, so that was good fun. Then I did some press-ups and some leg lifts, and now I feel ready for the day. You've got to set yourself goals for the day, because if you don't, you have a really crap day basically. So always set yourself a goal for the day and then you feel satisfied. So anyway, this is just a little video about the equipment that I use. These are Oakleys. They've been brilliant. I mean, I'm the worst owner of everything. I break it all, so everything here is pretty tough. This is my second GoPro. The first one I had lasted 1 hour and it broke. The software crashed and it was just crap, so they wouldn't give me any help or anything, and it was just out of its 12-month warranty when I first used it. So here we go again. GoPro, I don't like your company ethics, but this camera seems pretty damn good. So, got a little selfie stick that goes with the GoPro. I just generally use this yellow float. A, I lose it, drop it, it's gonna come to the surface and I'll, well, definitely see it. Also, this watch here, best utility watch I've ever had. Literally, I bought it from Greece, funny enough, and that's where we are now, as you can see. Sunbed, 35 degrees, pool, ocean. And this brickwork's amazing. Anyway, I am digressing. There's a little balcony. But yeah, go back to this. Literally bought this in Greece. Best watch I've ever had. It's solar powered. It's an analog 200-meter eco drive sports watch. Depth meter, so it tells you when you go down. It's got rapid ascent alarm. It's got basically everything you need from a dive watch, I'd say. And it's got a bit of weight to it. Yet again, it is tough because I own it and it hasn't broken in years. So really like this piece of kit, and it's got really nice engraving on the back. Straps amazing, and yeah, I've only ever been down to 15 meters, but it recorded it accurately, and then I hit the bottom and had to come back up. But I do like free diving, so that's what this is for. I love this mask, it never steams up really. And it was bright yellow. I left it in the sun obviously because I didn't know what's doing. And then a guy at the Dive Star shop in Spencer's Wood basically said, get a load of hand sanitizer, slap it all over it, leave it for an hour or two, wash it off, and yeah, it's come up all white again. So I'm really chuffed with that. And the mask is real clear clarity, tempered glass. It wasn't the most expensive, and the strap is amazing. You just put that on the back of your head, pull it, click it, and it really works. But yeah, this mask I'd recommend to anyone. It fits my face, quite a narrow face. Even my wife nicks it off me because she loves it too. And then this GoPro is amazing. It's the Hero 8, and this one seems pretty bomb-proof. I love the LCD back screen, and all you need, I'm gonna try and figure out how you put this onto this, because I've seen it in a lot of YouTube videos where you can camera mount it to the mask. So no idea how that works, but I've got some things here. I'll figure that out. But yeah, this is amazing. 4K, it's the 8 Black Hero Edition. And all I've really got is the waterproof case and this floaty thing. Mrs. will probably use that a lot more than me, but yeah, all good. But that is pretty much all you need to have a little sports collection. And if you love going free diving, I don't have any flippers yet, I'm gonna buy them. Probably the Apex ones, because they seem pretty good, which the Army use. But yeah, this is my little collection, and this is all you need to have fun. And an iPhone 11 Pro, which seems all right. It's got a reasonable camera and it's waterproof. I haven't broken it yet.